So here's my solution. I make a field called action of the same size as the grid, where I memorize for each cell what action it took to get there. So for example, if in the gold cell over here, it took an action of go down to get there from the previous cell, then this cell over here would have the action index for the action down. That's a little bit tricky, but it turns out to be really easy to program. In my node expansion routine, where I go from x to x2, which we talked about before, I now add just a single command for the successor state x2 and y2. I memorize the action it took to get there. Notice I don't associate it with x and y, the from state. And the reason is, in the from state, I'm trying out many different actions and I don't yet know which one succeeds. But when I hit the to state and expand it for the first time, then this is going to be the expansion that's part of the optimal path. So I associate the action with the successor state, not with the originating state over here. Very subtle, very important. If you got this right, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Now I have a field that memorizes for all these states over here the action it took to get in there, but I don't have this wonderful representation as I have over here. This will be compiled into a field called policy or plan, which I initialize with blanks, but it was the same size as grid. This is the field over here, which I eventually print out down here. In that field, I set the location of the goal explicitly to be the star, which is happening over here. And then I go from the goal backwards. I iterate from the goal location, x and y, now in backwards order all the way to the start, and do this as long as x and y haven't become my initial location yet. And I apply the inverse action. So I find the originating state by taking my current state and subtracting the action exactly the same way I added it before, using my action field as finding out what action was actually being used. In doing so, the first time I do this, x and y was the goal state, and x2, y2 become the state before. I happen to know in the goal state that the action was a down action. If I apply the negative of it, I go up and find myself over here. I then mark the policy field for the originating state to be the special symbol associated with this specific action over here. And then I recurse. I set x and y to the state x2, y2, and I then go a step further. In doing so, I will reverse the path step by step, print the associated action, and get exactly this table over here. Very tricky, but look, this is an advanced artificial intelligence class. You might as well program something really tricky. Took me a while to program it myself, but I finally got it right too.